Hey, what is up guys? I'm actually glad that I'm making this video right now and not earlier, because the thing is, before this set came out, I thought the Legendary Collection Kaiba was going to be one of the best sets in 2018. In fact, I even had the idea that this set would be the best set ever. I'm really wrong about that, because the thing is, although the cards are actually really great with all their reprints of Ash Blossom and everything like that, these cards are really hard to pull, and the thing is, sometimes you can get bad boxes. Now, today, the store that a lot of my friends pre-ordered at finally released the Legendary Collection, and they all opened up their own boxes. What I found was that out of an entire case, only one or two Ash Blossoms can be found in it. So that's quite unfortunate there. I had one friend who managed to pull one card of Demise, I had another friend who managed to pull some drone lockbirds and stuff like that, but overall the card ratios are pretty bad and you can barely make your money back. I mean, when I say barely, I mean in the sense that you're actually I guess you're getting a fair trade off it. So yeah, if you're really lucky, you might get an Ash, which will definitely make back your money and everything else comes as an extra. But if you don't get Ash, then you're either barely making back your money, or you're either there just to get it for collector's purpose. But overall, I found that this set was pretty disappointing in terms of how they actually put the cards in the pack so that you could actually pull certain cards. Overall, I ended up not buying this set at all because I think, I don't know, I just had a feeling that it wasn't worth it, and I guess that's correct here, because I found that a lot of my friends didn't get the cards that they wanted. Some of them couldn't get anything at all. Like, some of the boxes, they couldn't get an Ash Blossom or any of the cards that most people were looking for. So I felt really bad for them, and yeah, it was just unfortunate. I feel like if you want to get into this set, you have to buy multiple boxes to be able to get something worthwhile. Firstly, it carries a small risk, of course, of you not pulling anything while you're spending a lot of money on this, but at the same time you're also dealing with several other factors as well. With the whole thing is like, sometimes you're just barely making your money back, and overall you're just wasting your time on this. Unless you're really looking for certain cards, or unless you're a collector of some sort and you're just opening these packs for enjoyment, I wouldn't recommend these. Now, one upside to this is that the Monster Reborn Lost Arts were actually released at the same time as well. Now, maybe some of you guys around the world actually already got yours a lot earlier than we did here, but over here in Australia, it just came out. So the thing is, some stores will require you to actually make three separate transactions at the stores on different days so that you can actually accumulate a $45 total purchase, so that you can actually get your Monster Reborn. However, in this particular store that most of my friends actually went to get their Legendary Collection Kaibas, they were able to actually get their Lost Art Monster Reborns immediately after buying the one box, which costs $49 right now in Australia. So not particularly a great price, because if you convert it to USD, and if you actually look at the retail price of American Legendary Collection Kaibas, it's definitely not worth it at all. So we are paying a lot more here in Australia, which is quite unfortunate. But that's basically what I wanted to say in this video, is that this set isn't particularly great unless you're a collector, unless you're looking for really specific cards, or unless you're looking for a majority amount of the cards. I really don't recommend this set. I rather would buy singles out of this instead. And the thing is, I actually want to build ABCs out of this because they're all secret rares, so I figure if my friends pull any, then I'll definitely be willing to buy them off my friends and stuff, because they're currently running around maybe $1.50 to $2 each for these reprinted ABCs. So I think that's pretty cool, but overall, yeah, that's all I wanted to say. I might sound a little weird because I do have a blocked nose or something right now, and I'm not particularly feeling well. I haven't been getting great sleep because the first 2 weeks of uni has been actually quite stressful. I'm already a little behind, so I need to catch up with my work. Haven't been able to sleep properly, and also on certain days I just have full classes that I even have to skip meals. So Hopefully I can get back on track here, but definitely do look forward to a lot more cool videos, because I already have a few that I've recorded, so do look forward to that. But in the meantime, hope you guys have a great day. I'll see you next time.